Lesson 1. Prepare carpentry tools and materials. The content standard, the learners demonstrate an understanding of the underlying principles in the preparation of carpentry and tools and materials. Performance standard, the learners independently prepares carpentry tools and construction materials based on the industry standard. Here are the learning outcomes of this lesson. You are going to prepare the materials and tools applicable to a specific carpentry job and request appropriate materials and tools in carpentry jobs. Carpentry is a skilled trade in which the primary work performed is the cutting, shaping, and installation of building materials during the construction of building ships, timber bridges, concrete formwork, etc. So the person who works in a carpentry industry are called carpenters. So they are traditionally work with natural wood and did the rafter works such as framing. Okay, then once dependent upon craftsmanship with simple mechanical aids. So the industry now relies largely on machines and equipments. So the materials, tools, and equipments that will be mentioned in this lesson are particularly important in carpentry work since these are the primarily used to put things together. Materials in carpentry. Lumber. It is any wooden material sawed or split into boards or timber. So they are most common carpentry materials in carpentry industry. Lumber. Nail. So they are a metal that has one end point and one end flattened for hammering. So they are used to fasten the woods in carpentry industry. So they are different types, different sizes, and different materials where the nails is made of. Screw. It is a metal that has a thread and is made of metal. It comes into different types and lengths. It depends of what kind of materials you are going to use in your carpentry application or projects. G-wire. It is a galvanized iron wire. It is a steel or iron wire coated with zinc, commonly used for fencing. So most are tinatawag nating alambre. G-sheet. Oh, they are the iron sheet. It's a steel sheet coated with zinc to prevent it from rusting. Epo. Parang yung sabubong natin. Okay, so they are made of metal that is flattened. Steel reinforcement. So nakikita natin yan if we are going to construct a post sa ating o mga poste sa ating itatayong bahay. So they are used to strengthen the concrete under the tension. Tools in carpentry. First is the pull push rule, the most common used to measure a quantity or a distance. O tinatawag nating metro. Plumb bob. Okay po. It is a heavy pointed tip suspended by a string which is used as a vertical reference line. Okay po. Ginagamit siya to identify the center or the pinaka-center ng itinatayo nating construction or ng ating project. Of course, the carpenter's pencil. They are a marking tool to mark the measurement na required sa ating project. O yung pasapo lapis para sa ating pangmarka. Marking gauge. It is a tool used for marking lines on woods or metal for cutting. It is also known as scratch gouge. Gauge. Okay po. Ganito ang paggamit niya. Pag na-identify na yung measurement, ginagamit siya to mark. Also as a measurement sa ating project. Level bar. It is a bubble reading level which indicates the levelness of the surface being tested. Okay po. Ginagamit siya para ma-indicate po yung level ng ating surface. For example, may project tayong table para po ma-identify kung pantay ang ginagawa nating table ay ito po ang ginagamit. Okay? Or sa ating mga poste kung pantay siya. So, ang bubble po dapat nasa pinakagitna na tinatawag natin guidelines. Kapag pahiga or horizontal or vertical or patayo. Level hose. It is a tool that uses water or liquid to determine the levelness of a surface. Ginagamit po siya para ma-identify po natin yung levelness po ulit ng ating surface but by using water or liquid. Just like in the example picture. Kapag yung dalawang poste ba natin, yung levelness ba niya ay pantay, pwede pong gamitin yung tinatawag nating level hose. Tri-square. It is a tool primarily used to test the flatness, squareness, or accuracy of a right angle. Ito po. Ito po yung paggamit o position dapat ng ating tri-square. The chalk line. It is tool used to mark long, straight, and flat surfaces. So, ginagamit siya po pang mark. O minamarkahan niya yung mahabang distance para malaman natin kung pantay or straight ang ating sinusukat o ating gagawin project. So, ito po siya. Kung paano siya gamitin at ang posisyon. Okay po. From distance to distance. Next is the steel rule. Most common po ang steel rule para po gawa po siya sa bakal para malaman po natin yung ating measurement and to test the right angles of our projects. Plane. It is a tool used for smoothing or taking out sharpness of woods, joints, or stocks. Okay po. Ito po ang tamang paggamit sa kanya o yung position. Para po maging pantay ang ating ginagawang wood project or ating mga proyekto, ginagamit po ito pampakinis. Next is the chisel. It is a tool used for carving woods and cleaning joints and saw cuts. For example, gumamit tayo ng kaway sa ating projects at kailangan nating mag-carve ng shapes, pwede pong gamitin ang chisel. So, may mga iba't ibang types of chisel na pwede natin gamitin sa iba't ibang types ng materials na ating gagawin. So, here are the three most common chisels used in carpentry. The bench chisel, ginagamit for chopping and trimming woods. Paring chisel, so ginagamit for careful trimming of woods. And mortise chisel, for heavy chopping of wood joints. So, ito po yung mga example pictures o itsura ng ating mga chisel. Ito po yung position o kung tama kung ganito po ang position kapag tayo ay gagamit ng chisel. Next, the hand saw. It is a tool used for cutting woods manually. So, it comes into different types. May mga types tayo ng hand saw o ginagamit sa ating pagpuputol ng kahoy. Crosscut saw. It is used to cut across the grain of the woods. And the rip saw, used to cut along the grains of the wood. along and cut across ay magkaiba po. Ah. For example, ito. Ito po yung position kapag tayo ay maglalagare. Next is the drill bit. Ito po yung ini-insert sa ating electric drill. Okay po, ginagamit ang drill bit sa pagbubutas ng mga kahoy or ng concrete sa ating mga pader o kahit saan man ang gusto nating butasan. Brace. It is a hand tool used with drill bits to bore holes usually in woods kapag magbubutas tayo kapag sa kahoy po. Okay? Next is the bench vise. It is a holding device attached to a workbench. It has two jaws that hold something in place. So, sila yung nakakabit sa ating working table, ginagamit po to hold the object. Bench vise. Bar clamp. It is a tool used to hold pieces of wood for nailing or gluing. Kapag meron tayong gustong pagdikitin na dalawa or mga kahoy po na pagdidikitin natin, ito yung ginagamit. Bar clamp. Ayan ang example ng bar clamp. Para kung sakaling maayos ang pagkakadikit ng ating mga kahoy. Paintbrush. Of course, the most common sa ating finishing products is the paintbrush. Oil stone. O yung bato sa paghahasa ng mga cutting tools natin. To sharpen the edges of the steel tools. Saw set. It is used to sharpen and adjust the distance of sawtooth from its blade. So, ginagamit to sharpen o yung i-adjust po yung ating mga ngipin sa ating mga lagare. Saw set. Ayan po ang itsura. Nail set. It is used to drive nails deeper in the wood surface that comes into different several sizes. So, may iba't iba tayong material sa carpentry, pwedeng wood or pwedeng concrete. So, iba't ibang nails po yung gagamitin natin. File. It is a case-hardened steel bar that has forward-facing teeth used for smoothening, cutting and shaping surface of wood or materials. So, ginagamit po natin to smoothen or cut or shape yung surface ng ating wood o ng anumang materials na meron tayo. Okay po, sa iba't ibang may mga types po tayo ng file. Meron tayong flat, meron tayong square, meron tayong filler, meron tayong round, triangle, half round and knife. Depende po kung saan natin gagamitin ang ating file. Jigsaw. Ito yung power tools or power saw na ginagamit to cut woods or other materials in a straight or curved manner. At kung may mga gusto tayong i-cut na malakihang kahoy o yung mga mabibigat na kahoy, ito po yung ating gagamitin. Jigsaw. Next, sander. It is a power tool that moves in particular or back and forth pattern to smoothen the surface of the wood. Ginagamit po talaga ang sander. It's a power tool po siya, de kuryente, para po i-smoothen yung ating ginagawang wood project. Sander. So, ito po. Electric drill. Ito po yung partner ng tinatawag nating drill bit. So, electric drill, it is used with drill bits to work round holes and drive bit to use it as a driving fastener. Kapag may bubutasan tayong hole sa ating kahoy or concrete, ito yung gagamitin. Ginagamit din siya para ikabit o i-fasten yung ating mga screw. Circular saw. Ito ay yung power saw ulit siya that has a abrasive circular blade that moves in a circular motion to cut different types of materials. So, ginagamit siya sa pagkakat ng different types of materials o carpentry materials natin in a circular manner. It has an adjustable plate para po ma-determine yung angle na ating puputulin. Router. Okay po. It is used to shape edges of woodworks. It has various bits that determine the shapes of the edges. So, kapag tayo ay magkakat o magsishape ng ating woodworks o ng ating mga kahoy, ito po ang ginagamit. Router. Then, screwdriver. So, most commonly po, gamit ang screwdriver, it is used to tighten or loosen the screws. So, there are different types of screwdrivers and sizes. The most commons are yung tinatawag nating flathead. Okay po. Also known as slotted screwdriver and the crosshead. Kasi pa-cross po ang ating screwdriver yung tip. Also known as Phillips screwdriver. Ayan po ang mga itsura ng ating mga types of screwdrivers na ginagamit in carpentry works. Of course, the claw hammer used for driving and pulling out nails. The mallet, it is a tool usually made of wood and used to drive chisels and dowels. Kapag gagamit tayo ng chisel or dowels, ito po yung ginagamit natin, mallet. So, what is dowel? Dowel are cylindrical pin made of wood and is cut into different lengths. Then, protractor. Okay po, ginagamit, used to measure the angles. The zigzag rule. It is a folding rule that consists of roll strips joined with hinges which allows it to be folded against each other to keep it short and foldable. Okay po, ginagamit siya to easily measure the parallel lines. May mga parallel lines tayong gagawin sa ating project. Then ito po yung ginagamit, zigzag rule. So now let's proceed sa ating kung may naintindihan kayo sa ating lesson. So first, so kung sino yung unang makasagot or sa inyong isipan pakisagutan ito. Kung tama po, okay lang. Kapag mali, basahin po ang ating module. So what is the picture in number 1? Yes, very good po. Pull, push, roll. How about the number 2? Yes po. The chalk marker. Yes. Number 3? Yes. Paint brush. And number 4? Plane. And number 5? G-sheet. Okay, here are the week 1 tasks para sa ating topic ngayong araw na to. So, may dalawang activity lang po kayong gagawin para sa week number 1. For learning task 1.1, gumamit ang papel pang grade 6, copy the table on page 7 of your module. Yung page 7 po isulat ang 5 carpentry tools na matatagpuan sa inyong tahanan. Okay po. Maghanap kayo ng carpentry tools na meron kayo sa inyong bahay. Isulat yon at saan ginagamit ang 5 nakita ninyong tools. Ito po ang format sa ating page 7, learning task 1.1. Gayahin nyo po yung table. Okay po. Yung limang materials na may kita ninyo. Na may kita ninyo sa inyong bahay at kung saan po siya ginagamit. Next, pangalawang activity is under the performance task. Okay po, gumamit ng bond paper at sundin ang ibinigay na format. Okay po. So, short bond paper po ang gamitin. For learning task 1.2, it is a performance task. Use short bond paper, pencil, ruler, and any coloring materials. Ito po yung gagawin. Draw 10 carpentry tools and 5 carpentry materials that you have in your home. So, mag-drawing ng 10 carpentry tools at 5 carpentry materials na matatagpuan sa inyong tahanan. Or kung wala kayong hindi sumakto sa 10, mag-drawing kayo ng 10 tools at 5 materials na pang carpentry. Okay po, na natutunan ninyo kung wala sa bahay, kung wala kayong gamit o wala kayong materials, kung ano po yung natutunan ninyo. Okay po. Ito po yung format na ilalagay ninyo sa bond paper. Okay po. Dapat po ito yung ayos. Pahiga po ha, pahiga. 10 box, then 5 box sa ilalim. Okay po. Para hindi tayo magkamali. Ayan po yung ating mga learning task 1.1 and 1.2.